Hello YouTube, it's StrunkMonk74 here, and I'm just bringing you a first impressions video of a new title I found on Steam. I was introduced to it by one of my clan members who I game with, and it's called Insurgency. And there's just a couple of things I just want to make give you a heads up on about this title before we go any further. It is currently at half price on Steam. I believe it's only currently for PC and Mac. The half price sale, I believe, ends on the 2nd of January 2014. So you have until then to get it at half price. After that, it goes up to full price. Full price in the UK is £14.99. That's pounds. I'm not sure what that works out to US dollars or anything like that. Also, just a little heads up, this is an early access release, so it's not even a beta stage. And I'm just going to tell you straight away from the start what my initial thoughts are on the game. I love it. I think it's absolutely fantastic for an early release. You know, it does have a few little bugs here and there. For example, there's a couple of times my game's crashed when there's been a big explosion nearby. It doesn't happen all the time, but sometimes for some weird reason, like if someone throws C4 and it detonates and I'm near it, and my game seems to crash. So there is the odd little bug like that. But for an early release, I have to say it's absolutely fantastic. Really, really is fantastic. So I just want to talk about the game really a little bit and just give you an idea what it's like. The gameplay you're watching in the background is a game mode called Skirmish, which is basically Conquest. There are a number of game modes that you can play. Skirmish is one of them. You also have game modes called Push, which is basically Rush. Strike, Search and Destroy, Firefight and VIP. Now I haven't played, the only game modes I've really played are Skirmish, Push and VIP. And VIP basically is one team has a VIP, you've got to get them to one of two extraction points on the map, and the defending team's got to stop them, and basically stop them by killing the VIP. If you kill the VIP before you've killed all the other players on his team, it doesn't matter. Once you've killed the VIP, the VIP team lose. The VIP team can only win by getting their VIP to one of the extraction points. So fairly straightforward. The other game modes I haven't really played. I'm going off something on Steam that tells me what game modes are there. So if they're not all released as yet, please don't get angry with me. I'm just following some information I've found. Like I said, I've only just found it. I've only started playing it. So you know, any information I give you here, let's put a little caveat on there that, you know, maybe just double check it. I'm not saying it's 100% accurate, but you know, I'm doing, giving you the best information I can with the limited amount of information that's out there. One of the things is the forums for this title currently are down, so we're just waiting for that to come back up and probably can get a little bit more information on it. But yeah, the game itself, I find it's absolutely fantastic. Certain people, you got to really change up your playstyle. Like for example, I've only ever really played, you know, titles like Battlefield, COD, Medal of Honor, you know, the usual suspects, the usual titles that are out there. I'm relatively new to gaming, so you know, I'm not an experienced gamer, so I haven't played titles like Rainbow Six or anything like that. Which I believe, you know, it feels like this game, from what I've heard and what I've seen and what other people have said, it's very much what this title seems to be like. And what I mean by that is unforgiving in so many ways. It's unforgiving. Friendly fire is on. At all times, friendly fire is on, and you soon learn that. There's no HUD, no minimap. It's basically like playing hardcore. The bullet damage is phenomenal. You know, like doesn't matter what weapon you're playing at. If you're playing, if you're up close, you know, one or two rounds, and you'll be taking someone out, without a doubt. Sniper rifles also very powerful. The bolt action sniper rifles, I believe, are a one-shot kill more or less anywhere they hit you, especially, you know, upper body upwards, possibly even lower, but I'm not 100% sure. I haven't sniped that much in this game, and but the nice thing is they balanced it. And One of the good things about this game, one of the features I really do enjoy about this game, is how they've tried to balance it. Now you would imagine, you know, sniper rifles being so powerful, bullet damage being so high, you know, there's been lots and lots of cover. You can see what the graphics are like. So you do have to be slow. It's very easy to miss someone who's just, you know, poking their head through a window or duck behind a vehicle or a bit of cover. You know, it's very easy to miss someone. So you would imagine there'd be a lot of camping. And you know, snipers all over the place. One of the really good things what they've done with this title is they've limited the classes you can have. So the classes, you know, the classes you have are the standard classes. You've got a sniper class, you've got the assaulter class, the support class. I think you've got a specialist class, which is basically like a spec ops type class, and you've also got the designated marksman class. So I think that's like a semi-auto sniper rifle. The weapons you have for each class at the moment, I think with the early release, it's only about two weapons per class, so not huge variety. But there's enough to keep you going and enough to make it entertaining. But the good thing is what they've done is they've limited, depending on the size of the map and player count, they've limited how many of each class you can have. So for example, if you've got, I think the largest maps I've ever seen are 32 player maps, and on those you can have two snipers per team. That's it, no more than that. You can have some a designated marksman in there as well, and then, you know, the other classes are also nicely balanced. So you know, there's a nice variety of classes, and it does force you to play different classes. So, you know, you may have a favorite class, but someone may have already got it. When you join the match, you know, that class, those classes might already be used up, so you're gonna have to play a different class. Some people might hate it, some people will, but for me, I think it's really good in that it makes people play outside of their comfort zone. It mixes it up, and each class, you know, it's got its pros, it's got its cons, and you really do have to remember what class you're playing and play to that class's strengths. If you try and run around as a sniper, for example, you try and run around as if you were playing an assaulter, you are going to be in all sorts of trouble. So yeah, I absolutely love it. Really well balanced, and you know, another thing they've done to balance this game out is how you respawn. So there's not really a huge amount of respawns. The respawns you have, they're basically each team, I believe, starts with three waves of reinforcements, I believe they're called. So when you start a match, you have three waves, and you can when you die, you have three chances to respawn without any problems. After that, you've got to keep capping. So, for example, in skirmish, you have to just keep capping flags. Every time you cap a flag or cap an area, you will then be allowed to have another wave of reinforcements come in. And it's basically, they've done it really nicely to try and make sure that people continue to play the objective no matter what. And sometimes you can have some, you know, like some really long games. I believe there is a time limit on each round, but often if you're playing with a team who aren't playing the objective, you know, that time limit, you don't even get close to that time limit, because you run out of reinforcements, because your team are just worried about kill farming. They're not worried about capping the objectives or taking the objectives or playing the objective. They just want to get their kills, and they, you know, you soon run out of reinforcements. It's so important to keep playing the objective. If you do that, you know, you give yourself a much better chance of winning a round. So overall, at the moment, I'd say if you're interested, if you like this sort of game, you know, if you like hardcore game modes, or you like a bit more realism to your game, you know, you're fed up with a little bit of all that running and gun gameplay. Seriously, if you've got a PC, have a look at this title. I'm surprised at how good it is for an early access. For now, that's me. I'm done. I'm out of here. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed the commentary. And let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Till next time, catch you later. Cheers. Bye.